Hello and welcome to this video tutorial on how to use R in ML Studio. ML Studio supports R today. You can bring in your existing R codes in ML Studio and run it in the same experiment with Azure ML provided learners and publish this as a web service via Azure Machine Learning. Azure ML Studio hosts a module called Execute R that enables embedding any R code into an experiment authored in ML Studio. Right now, I'm logged into my ML Studio environment using my live ID. To start embedding R code in ML Studio, I will add the Execute R module to my experiment canvas. The Execute R module has three input ports and two output ports. The first two input ports take datasets, and the third input port takes a zip file. The first output port is a result dataset, and the second output port is the output port for R. Let's take a look at the default script that's provided for the Execute R module. This script takes two datasets bound to the two input ports and combines them using RBind function in R. It then uses the plot function from the base R package to plot this data and also redirects this dataset to the output port. I'm going to pick a simple sample dataset, the iris dataset, and connect both my input ports to this dataset. So what this should do is it should take the iris dataset, which has 100 rows, and with this script, I should get a resulting dataset that has 200 rows. It should also take the iris dataset and use the plot function in R to plot this. Let's run the script. The script is done running. Let's take a look at the output. The first port has the result dataset. Let's take a look at this dataset. Sure enough, this dataset now has 200 rows. Let's also take a look at the output port. You can see here the plot that was generated by calling the plot function in the base R package. Let's go back to the R script and edit a little. I want to now, instead of binding these two data sets, want to run the install R packages and have the results of this call be set into a data frame called data.set. I am going to delete these because I don't want any input port mapping. I don't want to plot this data set either. Okay, so this is what I have now. Let's run the script. The script is done running. To view the output, let's go to the output port for R. You can see the list of the packages that are installed for the default R environment in ML Studio. We had also redirected the output to the results dataset. Let's see what that looks like. You can see that each of the rows for every packet that the install packages function returned is listed as a row in this table. There are 396 rows, which means that 396 packages that are installed. This view is not very useful as the summary statistics don't mean much. Nevertheless, you can see the data frame has been converted as a data set for you to view. Now let's talk about the third port for input to R. This port takes a zip file. I have a very simple function that I have written in R. All that this function does is call summary on the data frame that's passed, and this function is called myprt. I'm going to save this as myrscript.r. I'm going to add this file to a zip file. To add this file to ML Studio environment, I go to New, Dataset, From Local Files, and I choose a zip file. Select zip as an option here, and you can upload this file into your ML Studio workspace. I've already added my zip file as a dataset. And you can see that it's right here as a saved dataset. I can drag this over here and connect this to my input port. Now, let me go back to my execute R script and add a few lines. I'm going to uncomment the dataset mapping. I don't need these two lines anymore. This function called source is going to pull in my R script, which is going to be unzipped into a folder called src. And then I have to provide the name of my script file. In my case, the file that I just showed you, my rscript.r, is a file that I need. Then I bind the two data sets from the input ports into a data frame called ds, and then I call my prt, the function that I had just saved, on this data set. Once I'm done, I then map this data set to the output port, and I'm going to get rid of this earlier file. So let's see how that works. Let's run the script. The experiment's done running. Let's take a look at the output port. As you can see here, that it pulled in my script.r function, and then it loaded the two data sets. And here it is. It called my prt function and printed the results of that, which was just a summary of the combined data set, into the output port. Also, like before, the combined data set is also mapped to the result data set port. There you have it, a simple way to embed your defined functions in ML Studio. Thank you for taking the time to view our in ML Studio tutorial.